Hello, folks. Clyde Lindsay here from Pixel Pro Displays. Thank you for taking the time to stop and check out today's video. Look, folks, today is something kind of different because, you know, we've got some things in X-Lites that just do not work the way I want them to. And the problem I have with that, well, I don't have a problem with that. It actually does work. I just have to think about things differently. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. Thanks for joining us again. Welcome back to the PPD YouTube channel. And today's video is going to show you something, well, non-standard. So if you get frustrated with trying to get your output set up correctly for a matrix, let's say you want to make a matrix panel that is on two outputs, but X-Lites only lets you put it on four or three, or, you know, this has been a really hard video for me to get started with, and I'll tell you why. Because when we deal with X-Lites, it's all about custom things inside your show, inside your display. The problem is that what I use may not be what you use. And so me sharing with you my exact experience doesn't always work. But the other day I received a private message from Mark, and he asked a brilliant question. And the challenge is how do I do this in X-Lites? And I'm gonna share this letter with you right now. Hey, Clyde, I'm trying to convert my way of using X-Lites so that my props are set up with the controller port info. This way I can push the configuration to the controllers. The issue I'm having is with the native X-Lites model, like a matrix. I have a window matrix that is 450 pixels total. It's 18 by 25. I would like for one output to control the first 250 pixels and a second output to control the next 200 pixels. I can't figure out how to tell X-Lites this is how the controller needs to be configured. Is this possible? Spoiler alert, totally possible. It seems like X-Lites has to have either one string of 450 with 18 strands or two strings of 225 with 9 strands each. Mark. I have to tell you, for 2 hours I've tried to record this video, and I said, you know what, this is a mailbag video, and I'm just going to have to use your example to explain to other people how this will work for you in the future. What I want to share with you, though, is this is my home layout, and as you can see here, I have a number of matrix panels, and if I click on any of my matrix panels, you'll notice that even though it says matrix, it's not actually a matrix panel. In fact, there's only two matrix models on my entire show. That's the P10, and that is this new, well, maybe that one over there, that one there, and this one here. These are new because I haven't configured them yet. All of my other matrix panels are all custom models right here, right along the front end of the house here. So all of these are custom models. And this is how we get around those challenges of having either 18 strands of so many pixels, or two strings, or one string. X-Lites is wonderful whenever it comes to doing things logically, but whenever you want to use unstandard methods for creating your props, that's what we're going to cover. Let's build Mark's model. So Mark's model, he says he wants two strands, one with 200 and the other one with 250. And after reading the letter, I'm going to assume that we'll just click on the matrix panel here. We'll click and drag and make a matrix panel out real quick. What we're going to do is he's using this for a window. So I assume if it's a window, I don't know, it could be horizontal, it could be vertical, I don't know. Make sure that you configure horizontal or vertically. That horizontal means left and right, and vertical means up and down. If you think of Megatree is vertical. It goes up and down. It doesn't go horizontal, even though maybe it possibly should. The matrix panels can go either way. And it all depends on which your specific scenario is. We're going to go with 18 wide by 25 tall. So to do that, well, obviously you can have 18 strings. We'll change this to vertical. 18 strings. There we go. Of 25. Now, this is the physical size of his window, but it's not the pixel layout of the window. So what we have to do is we have to tell X-Lights, hey, I need to make this model with one string. And then when we do that, now he already mentioned this, he alluded to this, we're going to create another one of these. We're going to create this using one string as opposed to, we said 18 strings, we're going to use one string here. And so, again, we start with a vertical. We'll go over and switch this to vertical. So we'll make them identical, and we're only going to use one string, 450 pixels. And remember, the strings per strand, that's the strands. There's 18 across here, so let's put 18 in here. And that, if we stretch this out, will create an identical model. And if we open this up and we look at the node layout, you can see that we have a total of 450 nodes. It starts down here at the bottom, goes up, over, down, over, up, over, down, over. And X-Lights does the same thing here if we go to the node layout. The only difference is it's saying, hey, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. It's 18 strings of 25, and that's 18 outputs. We only want two outputs. So neither of these models is going to work, but this model here will work for us to create our custom model. And how we do this is we right click and we're going to go and look for export as custom X-Lights model. So I'm going to call this Matrix 4 Mark. And what we'll do next is we will go ahead and use the import function. We'll click and drag. We will go search for that model, so Matrix for Mark, and we'll import it. Now you'll see that instead of, see how this says Matrix 4, this says Matrix 5. This is now a custom model where you have the ability to edit each and every single one of the Matrix pixel locations, right? So whereas this here, this doesn't have that dialog box. But what this opens up for us in X-Lights is the ability to come down here and set our individual number of strings. So the first thing, Mark wants to use two strings, right? He wants to use two strings. And as soon as you do that, X-Lights gives you this individual start node option. Click the checkbox. Remember, this was only one string. And it exported as that and it imported as that. Now, instead of having to worry about the problem with the X-Lights matrix model, now we can use the X-Lights custom model and tell it exactly what pixel number that we're going to place in which specific output. So what we can do is we can assign our port down here, but we can also say pixel number one starts on string number one. And then over here, he's saying that he wants to put 250 pixels on the first output. So 251, pixel number 251, is going to be where his second string starts. So you'll sequence with this prop, and you'll output it to lights with this prop. You don't need this model at all whatsoever. Once you've created this, you can delete it. But after you've exported it, then imported it, then you get the option or the ability to convert it into two outputs. And this is how we can test this. Look at the node layout. Now, unfortunately, the node layout doesn't do the nice, cool thing where it changes the color to show that there's a designation of one output versus another output, which would be really cool enhancement. But what it does do is it shows you, see how it says node 100, string 1, node 200, string 1, node 250, string 1. Node, now look at this one here, node 251, string number 2. So right here, this whole section right here is all string number 2. Let's go ahead and assign this to a controller so that we can see what it physically looks like when we add this into the controller for the visualizer. I'm going to change the name of this to Mark. We'll go ahead and select the start channel and go open up the dialog box here, and we're going to connect this to one of our controllers. And I click on Universe here, and I'm selecting the controller IP address that I'm associating this prop with, and the start universe is number one on it, we'll say. And let's go back in. We can click Save here, go to the Controller tab, and we come over here, and here is Mark's controller. Surprise, surprise. And let's go ahead and bring up the visualizer. So we should be able to see Mark's matrix right there with the custom model. And we, if we bring it over here and drag it over to pixel port number one, you can see that port number one has 250 strings, and port number two has 200 strings. So that's how, if you're looking to keep full numbers on a pushed prop, but still be able to use the model that X-Lites creates, what we have to do, what we've learned we had to do, is we had to come back in here and we had to create a custom model instead of using the standard X-Lites model. But that's the idea behind today's lesson, guys. So if you like the video, hit the big like button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done yet. So if you have any questions, by all means, use the comments below and let us know what you think of the video. Also, if you have other questions related to X-Lites or the RGB pixel hobby in general, we're happy to answer them, as we did Mark's great question here. You can contact us inside, and you can communicate and become a member of the PPD community by going to Pixel Pro University on Facebook. There is a link in the video description. If you appreciate the content that we do here at Pixel Pro Displays, consider joining the PPD Sequence Club. One awesome sequence is given away each month if you join the club for a monthly or an annual membership, and that is that's the way we try to help the community, is by offering great sequences, great prices, and giving you great content here on YouTube. So guys, thank you for joining us in today's tips and tricks video. Thank you, and we will see you next time.